Hello, it's Connie Erickson with another episode of Live at Five. And I'm happy to be back, recovered from my flu. Thank you for all the nice messages. I really appreciate it. It was kind of brutal. I don't remember being sick for that long ever. So, anyway, today, and I might have a little cough still, so bear with me. Okay, today I wanted to talk about loving and being in love. And I started thinking about this because the first round of my couples communication course just wrapped up, and I'm thinking about when to launch it again. And the last time it ran, it attracted seasoned couples. One of them was married for, I don't know, over 25 years. But couples that have been together a long time who know the importance of good communication, so that's why they were taking the course to kind of bone up on that. But I know a lot of people in this group are engaged or newly married or first living together, and I just wanted to talk about that transition and why communication is so important. And it, you know, I don't know what everybody else knows, so I've been doing this a long time and I've read a lot, so maybe you guys know this already. So if so, drop a comment and tell me. But if not, hopefully it's valuable information. But in the beginning, relationships are easy, right? You see your partner and quite literally they turn you on and they make you happy. And biochemically, there's a good reason for that. When we're first in love, our brains, hi RB, when we're first in love, our brains release tons of PEA, phenylethylamine, and it's a powerful amphetamine. So you have that state of euphoria, you're talkative, you want to have sex all the time, you're on top of the world. It triggers the brain's reward system. So it's really not unlike a lot of other addictive substances. It's kind of a lot like cocaine, and like any other addict, you want to be with your drug all the time. And my dog wants to be with her food, but she's gonna have to wait a couple more minutes. Anyway, that wonderful in love stage is not meant to last. Biologically, it can really only last for somewhere between 18 months and 4 years. Then, like with other drugs, we develop a tolerance. Not coincidentally, this is about how long it takes for people to fall in love and procreate. So, from an evolutionary standpoint, PEA is a great thing. That feeling in love is what brings us together. But, and I hope this doesn't bum you out too much, feeling in love is not what keeps us together. In fact, that in love feeling is not a prognostic indicator. So meaning that, and this truly has been studied, that there is zero correlation between that feeling in love and the length or the success of a relationship. So I actually think that's great news because let's face it, we're not very much in charge or in control of our feelings of infatuation. I don't know about you, but I've been infatuated with some people that did not end up being good partners. And that was probably several times in high school alone. But if you communicate, if you nurture the relationship, those in love chemicals are replaced with endorphins. And so it's more like morphine than speed. Your relationship helps you feel good in a different way. Those chemicals kill pain, they help you survive some of the sadness that is life. Those chemicals kill pain, they calm the mind, they reduce stress. People in solid relationships are more chill, they're more able to take things in stride, and they're more secure. So unlike the addict, you know, checking their phone to see if their beloved one texted, the person with long-term love chemicals, they know they have a good thing. They're not they don't have that addictive behavior. And that's why I run my couples communication course, talking to your partner whether you're feeling in love or not, nurtures the friendship, and that's what keeps us together. Having the tough conversations kindly is what builds that foundation. Think of your relationship as your new home. You want it built on a rock solid foundation. Think of you want it to be able to provide a soft place to land, be your shelter, refuge from the storm, and all the elements of life that inevitably wear on your soul and your relationship. So that in love phase is like that fantasy, like, ooh, where do you want to live? What should our house look like? And you imagine the details and the rooms and the decor. It's a really cool time, but before the actual building takes place, you need a good plan. You need a solid foundation, and without a solid foundation, it's, the proverbial castle in the sand. We've all known relationships that started out completely in love and then ended. Every relationship, sorry, is eventually peppered with challenges from time to time. You might choose to have kids, people get sick, people change jobs, there's financial challenges, and not to mention the family that you came from. And good foundation, good communication and friendship make up the foundation for solid long-term relationships. That's what creates those endorphin chemicals that help you be in it for the long haul. So, my hope is that I give you valuable information and tips every time you listen or read or look at this group. That's my goal, and that's really important to me. But especially if, so that's true whether you sign up for the course or not, but especially if you're first starting to plan your lives together, I would consider signing up for the course. Good communication and friendship make up the foundations of long-term relationships. And in the course, and hopefully a little bit here, I teach what will be the bedrock of your relationship and the foundation to tackle every challenge that will inevitably come up. And whether you decide to take the course or not, if you're new to your relationship and just starting out your lives together, please make sure you take the time to plan your relationship foundation, not just the wedding, the honeymoon, and where you live, because that's the foundation that's going to take your relationship through the rest of your lives. So I hope that was helpful. Please drop a comment and questions, and I hope to see you next week. Thanks a lot.